about gravity, you know. Do you know it would be so nice to call him gravity? Like, yo, people, check this out. I got some bad news there. You know, gravity would... Lolo. Oh, yes! What today is it? Today it is Thursday. Okay. Given it is a Thursday, we all know that I do a video review. So today, I'm going to review some, but I would like to shout out to Palazzo. What's good, son? I just saw your new music. Okay, I'm going to get back to you on that one later on in the show. But for now, though, my name is Tina Pierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Okay, at the crack of dawn, according to me, though it happened way, way earlier, at the crack of dawn, we got some weird news. Yes, for me, I call it weird because we didn't see it coming. Now, the story is that Gravity Omtuju was shot. And he is not in critical, or he's in critical. Everybody has their own saying, but from my trusted sources, they say he's stabilized, he's not in critical condition. He got first aid immediately when it happened. And the details are still very, very shaky, if you ask me, because they say he was at a petrol station trying to fuel up, and they were headed to a performance. Now, Mbu, this is where it gets confusing. As they were at the fuel station, the askari at the fuel station or at the gas station, depending which country you're coming from. My goodness, why am I fading after this story? Because I know for a fact it's confusing. Anywho, it's alleged that he was at a petrol station. He was waiting for the other lead car. They were getting fuel and he was going out to do a performance. Now, what happens is that as he was waiting, the security at the police station opened fire. Reason why that happened, they have no idea. Now, all of this went down in a place called Kasanda, of all places. Kasanda, some name that I don't understand. But let me break it down for you. This is how simple it is. Kasanda is investigating a case of attempted murder by shooting to the prejudice of one Wabuyo Gilson. This guy is Blijo called Gilson. Gilson. How did you become Gravity Omtuju? Anyway, he's at 25 years. He's a Munyore. Gravity is a Munyore Blijo. Okay. Now I understand. He's a musician from Munyonyo Makindye Division. This happened at LK Petrol Station, Bukuya County, Kasanda District. Now, the incident happened at exactly 21:45, or should I say 22 hours. It's alleged that the singer was heading to Lwebitu Tet Trading Center for a show and made a stop over at the fuel station, waiting to be led to the venue after fueling. The security guard, only identified as Muhebwa Amos, fired at his crew. Motive yet to be established. Victim sustained injuries around the stomach, rushed at Blue Star Clinic, Bukaya, for first aid in a stable condition. Three suspects arrested, rifle recovered, scene covered, inquiries are at hand. Now, let's leave alone the fact that we have found out pretty much everything about Gravity Omtuju. This is very, there's a missing link here. There's a missing link. Because I looked at the photos. I've seen the photos of the smashed car. I've seen the photos of him after he got, what's it called? He got first aid. Now, the question here that everyone is trying to understand, was he shot? Because according to this, they are saying they fired at his car. According to the photos that I've seen, I don't think those were gun wounds. I think those were pretty much scuffle and glass and all those, the things that happen when something that scary is happening. I don't, because if it's a wound, they were dressed too tidily. You could think if it was a wound and there were bullets, it would be a through the stomach. Or else, if it's not a through and through, they would definitely have to cut him open and have to remove the bullet. But no, that didn't happen. As of now, we are not sure why these guys actually fired at them. Now, I can tell you one thing about Gravity. Gravity is one guy who is actually calm. The problem is probably the people around him, because I am thinking this is a one of them situations like with the Kusasa Sida and Kasidia Gwanga moments, where they went into an altercation that has not been started and given, and this guy lost his cool. It's probably dead in the, it was not even probably, it was dead in the night. Askari is tired, these guys look like thugs, he's not having it, blah 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 blah. But those are all just assumptions. But this goes to, without saying, Nzanga sinaba kunenya muntu yena, kansoke nenye government. I do not know who is in charge of who gets which licenses to hold or carry a gun in this country anymore. I do not know. At this rate, I feel everybody owns a gun, whether they know how to work it or not, whether they have post-traumatic stress or whether they have... They could be schizophrenic at this point. If they want a gun, they will get it. I want to understand why we have so many guns in hands of people who don't know how to control and keep their temper. This is not the first time an artist has been shot. Yes, you're going to say, yeah, they shot Bebe Cool, blah, 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 he got paid. But just think about it. Just think about it. The only thing that scares me in this country lately is the fact that anyone could be laced at any given moment. Everyone is carrying. Anyway. We are still waiting for the final reports, and when they do come out, I'll definitely share with you. But it is safe to say Gravity is very okay. Not very okay, of course. He's traumatized, he's in pain and all those things, but he is stabilized. I don't think there's anything bigger than that at this moment. The fact is that Ali Bulunji, for now, let's wait and he'll give us his version, his story of what exactly went down. Ooh, child, Palazzo Dan went and got him some new management. He out here putting new music out, new videos. I was like, wow, child, Palazzo, what's good? What's popping? What's happening, daddy? You know why I'm saying this? Because we all thought for a fact he would not come up with music that could somewhat interest us. Now, he's had music that would somewhat interest us, but I didn't expect him to get music that would make me go like, okay, interesting. So his new song, Wine and Wine. First of all, I had to big it up for, yes, it's another Sasha Vibes crime. Some of my tweeners, it is the shorties, I feel woo, woo, overhead and all of that. But I would love to say I love the video because it has a lot of pop of color. I love the fact that it was done by the beach and the sand looked whiter than usual. What else am I thankful for this video? It's good to watch. I can't say it's that nice. I can't say it has a storyline as usual. Palazzo's videos never have storylines, even the one where he was singing for his mom, apart from the fact that she was seated in the video. They just never have a storyline. Anyway, video is dope. It's good to watch because it's very colorful. When something is colorful, it immediately invites your senses to want to watch it. Now let's talk audio. Wine and Wine. Oh, Palazzo, Palazzo, Palazzo. I do not know, but you need to talk to management to get you a writer. If this is your work, honey, boo pie, boo tang, I'm sorry to break it down to you. Your lyrical prowess is lacking. It is actually not just lacking, it is non-existent. I just listened to a song where all they were saying, I wanna go, I wanna go, I wanna go, I wanna go, I wanna go. I'm like, wait, wait. Did someone press that Ka Ebi button on a remote? I can't. But the song is good though. The visual is good. If you take away the sad fact that the lyrical content isn't deep enough for such a beautiful video, it can pass. So kudos, Palazzo. So you have two new songs out. I'm pumped. I want to watch the second one. I mean, I always say this. The Mayanja family is very, very talented. Each and every one of them has a musical thing to them. But I always say the fact that Palazzo among the Mayanja families, yeah, the Mayanja family, yes, the others do hardcore, ragamuffin, blah, blah, blah. But for Palazzo, it's different. He can actually sing, so, you know, I'm excited. I would want to watch another one of these days, yeah. I'm trying so hard this year. I'm trying to see if I see talent anywhere, even if it is just underground and I feel the talent is there, I'm going to want to share with you guys. And then you can always hit us up, comment section. Let us know if you think this artist is going to go a place or not go a place. Give us your valid reasons. We can bake or make the next artist. We can actually decide which artist we want in ours. Do you know how cool that is? We can get to decide which artists we want to be in our industry, what artists we want to sing for us. So yes, let's start 2019. Every time I do a video review, if I do something from someone that is little less known, I would love for you to hit me up in the comment section. Let me know what you think, what the vibe is, and you know, just give us opinion. Let's find out. So yesterday I talked about Mugaba. I reviewed his first video. It was In My Bed by Mugaba. Now he recently dropped his second single and I was so pumped, I was excited. They hit me up, they're like, yo, check out our new single. Now the new single is called Controller. First of all, the video was shot by a co-worker. Oh, he was a co-worker. So I'm kind of excited to see one of my co-workers turn into another Sasha Vibes crime. I hope he makes it to the Sasha Vibes levels because, I mean, we're living nothing but the dream. Controller by Mugaba. If you ask me when I compared controller to In My Bed, I was still in love with In My Bed. In My Bed was such a beautiful song. It showed his vocal range. It showed how lazy he can be with it and still manage to serenade you. With Controller though, it's a different vibe. You have to understand, they're two different vibes. And I understand that bit, but I think I still prefer, you know, the first song, because the first song was really a good successful hit. First of all, big up to you, Ivush. I love the lighting in this video. I love the vintage lighting. I love the fact that you sat down with his management and actually directed an entire video. You tried to give it a very bigger meaning. When you're watching the video, it's like you're just watching the video until it hits you when the video ends, that it was all but a dream. I was like, interesting. Okay. Not bad. But other than that, yes, the lyrical content, it's there. The music, the singing, yes, he can really sing. I have a problem with how much autotune was put in Controller. If you put that all aside, this is a boy who is headed for something. He's headed for something because I've sat down with him. He's a talented man. He's a very talented man. And I'm excited. I'm pumped for his new music that's coming out. So, meanwhile, Ebintubia, what's his name? Cheyune. Eddie Cheyune, man. Damn, son. I just got some critical information about these guys. Oh, well. And then I was reading some post he had put up in January. He's like, Munde Kendia sent us and I hustle hard for this money. Say, share that sentiment again now. Bam, sibi atoyo takenda kuvayo lero. Woo, regardless of how many times he's going to bribe, if he can bribe. But you know, we are not taking corruption. We're not taking it into these things. No, we won't. Anywho, I'll get back to you with the deets on that as soon as they come through to my desk, because they're actually bigger, juicier parts of this story that you may not actually have understood. @TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and @TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, it's @TinaFierce1 with an H. I'm out. I'll catch you again tomorrow. It's going to be your Friday, baby. I'm out. Peace.